Hi, my name's Elena. We're back with Alex and Eber from the story plot of Friend or Foe. We're going to go ahead and go over episode 4 in a little bit and talk about how they incorporate communication.
Okay, so in this episode, after getting off the last one, the king has gone completely mad. He's hiding in his quarters. He doesn't want to come out. His number one communicator, Julian, also the number one jester, is trying to negotiate with him to come out, as well as appoint roles for David and Luis on what they want to do about the situation.
Okay, so I know for communication, there's 4 parts to it. There's the encoding, the sending, the receiving, and the decoding, but I also noticed that for one particular character, you only used one of those. So can we talk a little bit more about that?
Yeah, so I went in depth with the communication role as far as Julian, as the screenwriter said. Julian plays the role of the communicator, and that means that he negotiates a term between the king and the knights. As the sender, he must eliminate the noise that he gets from the note and interpret the message correctly. As far as that, it's kind of hard for him to do that because he is in a lower rank of a centralized hierarchy, and he has to overcome the communication barrier to persuade the king to let him know, hey, like, it's safe for you to be outside.
Gotcha. Yeah. Okay, thank you guys.